Hello everyone, welcome once again to Top 10 Blue Bulls. Today we are going to talk about Kenyan tribes.
Kenya has around 44 tribes officially recognized, each contributing to the country's diverse and rich culture and heritage. These tribes are known for their unique history, culture, values, lifestyle, language, religion, food, much more. As rural Kenyans migrate to urban centers in pursuit of employment, leisure, and other economic development activities, most of Kenya's large cities have become densely populated with people from different ethnic tribes. Kenyans in urban centers largely speak English and Swahili as official and national language respectively, while still retaining some of their native culture and ethnic languages. It is the diversity of Kenya's tribes and their individual cultures that have made Kenya such an adorable and unique country. Though many distinctions between many tribal groups are slowly being eroded as people move to major cities for work and some intermarry, these 10 tribes, in no particular order, are among the largest, most influential, distinctive, and most notable in Kenya. Number 10, the Taita people. The Taita people make up of 0.1% of the population. They originally came from what is now the Tanzania and first settled in the region around Voi and Taveta in Kenya's far southeast around 10 centuries ago. The Taita language belongs to the Bantu group of languages and similar to Swahili, although such is their interaction with other tribes that their language has imported many words from neighboring tribes, including the Kikuyu. The Taita social life was traditionally dispersed and strongly territorial, with each clan inhabiting a discrete area of the Taita Hills, south of what is now the Tsavo West National Park, and first settled in the region around Voi and Taveta in Kenya's far southeast around 10 centuries ago. It was only after colonization that a collective sense of Taita identity developed in earnest, a process accelerated by the intrusion of the railway line through Taita lands. Taita religion was largely animist in nature, with sacred meeting places and elaborate burial rituals. The defining features, although few Taitas now live according to traditional ways. Number 9, the Swahili. The Swahili people are around 0.6% of the total population. Although these people of the coast do not have a common heritage, they do have a linguistic link, Kiswahili, commonly referred to as Swahili, a Bantu-based language that evolved as a means of communication between Africans and the Arabs, Persians, and Portuguese who colonized the East African coast. The word Swahili is a derivative of the Arabic word for the coast, Sawahil. The cultural origins of the Swahili, who make up of 0.6% of the population, come from intermarriage between Arabs and Persians with Africans from the 7th century onwards. In fact, many anthropologists consider the Swahili as a cultural tribe brought together by trade routes rather than tribe of distinct biological lineage. A largely urban tribe, they occupy coastal cities like Mombasa, Malindi, Lamu, and Stone Town, Zanzibar. And given the historical Arab influence, the Swahili largely practice Islam. Number 8, the Maasai. Despite representing only a small proportion of the total population of 2%, the Maasai are for many the definitive symbol of Kenya. The reputation of fierce warriors, the tribe has largely managed to stay outside the mainstream of development in Kenya and still maintains large cattle herds along the Tanzanian border. British gazetted the Masai Mara National Reserve in the early 1960s, displacing the Maasai, and they slowly continued to annex more and more Maasai land. Resettlement programs have met limit to success, as the Maasai traditionally scorn agriculture and land ownership. The Maasai still have distinctive style and traditional age-grade social structure, and circumcision is still widely practiced for both men and women. Women typically wear large plate-like bead necklaces, while the men typically wear a red checked shuka, a blanket, and carry a distinctive ball-ended club. Blood and meat are the mainstays of the Maasai diet, supplemented by a drink called mursik, made from milk fermented with charcoal, which has been shown to have lower cholesterol. Number 7, the Meru. Originally from the coast, the Meru now occupy the northeastern slopes of Mount Kenya and represent 6% of the population. Up until 1974, the Meru were led by a chief called Mogwe, but upon his death, the last incumbent converted to Christianity. Strangely, many of the tribal stories mirror the traditional tales of the Old Testament. The practice of ancient worship, however, is still widespread. They have long been governed by an elected council of elders, the Njurinjeke, making them the only tribe practicing a structured form of democratic governance prior to colonialism. The Meru now live on some of the most fertile farmland in Kenya and grow numerous cash crops. Subgroups of the Meru include the Chuka, Igembe, Goji, Taraka, Mudambi, Tigania, and Imenti. Meru region is known for miraa or cut production. Number 6. Yakamba. The region east of Nairobi towards Tsavo National Park is the traditional homeland of the Bantu-speaking Yakamba, who make up of around 11% of the total population. Great traders in ivory, beer, honey, iron, weapons, and ornaments. They traditionally plied the trade between Lake Victoria and the coast and north to Lake Turkana. In particular, they traded with the Maasai and Kikuyu for food stocks. Highly regarded by the British for their fighting ability, they were drafted in large numbers into the British Army. After World War I, the British tried to limit their cattle stocks and to settle more. Nowadays, they are more famous for their elegant Makonde-style ebony carvings. Yakamba society is a clan-based, with all adolescents going through initiation rites at about the age of 12. They are also known for their hot and charming beauties, hence their heavy presence in their art and multimedia industries. Number 5. The Gusii. The Gusii people, who are around 6% of the total population, occupy the Western Highlands east of Lake Victoria, forming a small Bantu group speaking island in a mainly Nilotic speaking area. Primarily cattle herders and crop cultivators, they farm Kenya's cash crops, tea, coffee, and pyrethrum, as well as vegetables. That's why the Kese region has become one of the breadbaskets of Kenya. They are also well known for their basketry and distinctive rounded soapstone carvings. Like many other tribal groups, Gusii society is a clan-based, with everyone organized into age sets. The medicine men, the Abanya Morigo in particular, hold a highly respected and privileged position, performing to the role of co-doctor and social worker. One of their more peculiar practices is trepanning and the removal section of the skull or spine to aid maladies such as backache or concussions. The Gusii are also known to be quite entrepreneurial in ventures, transport, and other industries like food production. Number 4. The Luo. The Luo live on the shores of Lake Victoria and are Kenya's third largest tribal group, with 13% of the population. This is a tribe of former US President Barack Obama's father. Though originally a cattle herding people like the Maasai, their herds suffered terribly from the Rinderpest outbreak in the 1980s, so they switched to fishing and subsistence agriculture. During the struggle for independence, many of the country's leading politicians and trade unionists were Luo. Socially, the Luo are unusual among Kenya's tribes. That family unit is part of a larger grouping of dot or families, several of which in turn makes up an Ogandi, group of geographically related people, each led by Ruoth or a chief, and there are many distinctive Luo instruments made from guards or wire strings. Today, the Luo are well known for their passion for academics. Other than education, they also have a heavy presence in arts and sports. The Luos, like the Luyas, are also known for some of Kenya's finest soccer talents. Number 3. Kalenjin. Kalenjin, who are around 12% of the total population, comprise of the Nandi, Kipsigis, Elgeyo, Marakwet, Pokot, and the Tugen, the tribe of Kenya's second president, Daniel Arap Moi. They first migrated to the area west of Lake Turkana from the South Sudan around 2000 years ago, but gradually filtered south as the climate became harsher. As with most tribes, the Kalenjin are organized into age sets. Administration of the law is carried out at the Kok, an informal court led by the clan elders. However, the tribe is most famous for producing some of Kenya's Olympic runners and champions. Close to 80% of Kenya's top runners are from the Kalenjin. Today, the Kalenjin land is largely agrarian and produce some of Kenya's leading cash crops like tea, maize, and livestock production in large scale. Number 2. The Luhya. The Luhya were around 14% of the total population, make up of 18 different groups, the largest being the Bukusu. The Bantu-speaking Luhya are the second largest group in Kenya, representing 14% of the total population. They occupy a relatively small, high-density area of the country in Western Highlands, centered in Kakamega. In the past, the Luhya were skilled metal workers, forging knives and tools that were traded with other groups. But today, most Luhya are agriculturalists, farming groundnuts, sesame, and maize. Smallholders also grow cash crops such as cotton and sugarcane. The Luyas are also largely superstitious and still have a strong traditional belief, though this is slowly fading away. Today they are also known to produce some of Kenya's sporting talents, mainly in football, rugby, volleyball and many others. And lastly, without guessing, is the Kikuyu, number one. The Kikuyu, who make up of 22% of the population, are Kenya's largest and most influential tribe. Kenya's first President Jomo Kenyatta, third President Mwai Kibaki, and the current one, Uhuru Kenyatta, son to Kenya's first president, are of Kikuyu tribes. The Kikuyu, who are famously warlike, overran the lands of Athi and Gumba tribes, come hugely populous in the process. Now the heartland surrounds Mount Kenya region, although they also represent the largest proportion of Kenyans living in Kenya's major cities, with territory bordering that of the Maasai. The tribes share many cultural similarities due to intermarriage. The administration of the Mwaki clans was originally taken care of by the Council of Elders. Each group of youths of the same age belongs to a rikan, or age set, and passes through the various stages of life and their associated rituals together with subgroups. Subgroups of the Kikuyu include the Embu, Ndia, and Bere. The Kikuyu are largely known for the entrepreneurial spirits, coupled with political landscapes and dispensations that have largely favored them. They now boast of the highest number of Kenyan billionaires. Today, the Kikuyu are also known for their gorgeous women and also have a heavy presence in Kenya's art and multimedia industry. There are many ethnic groups in Kenya, and if you feel there's any other tribe I should have mentioned, please share in the comment section below. I'll be glad. You're all welcome for your views and opinions. Otherwise, thanks for watching.